Okay, Joe.
Finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three: Norris, Leclerc, and Max Verstappen. With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big race Welcome once again then to the United States Grand Prix here in the magnificent city of Austin. It was here in 2018 that Kimi Raikkonen delighted the world by taking the top step of the podium for the first time in 114 races. There's always a record to be broken, so what, I wonder, is in store for us here today? It's the Circuit of the Americas then, situated 14 miles outside of the great city of Austin. This is a 3.6 mile lap with 20 corners, 10 to the left and 10 to the right, and top speeds of around 200 miles per hour. Overtaking opportunities are available into turns 1 and 12, especially with that rear wing DRS wide open. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Oscar Piastri, George Russell, Moore, Verstappen, they've taken a grid penalty, Ocon, Gasly, and Kevin Magnussen, Bottas, Leclerc, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, Guan Yu Zhou, and Stroll, Vettel, Tsunoda, Robert Schwartzman, and Mick Schumacher, Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. And a warm welcome to Natalie Pinkham, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Why don't we kick off by discussing Max Verstappen? There's a new gearbox in the back of that car, which means a grid penalty and hopefully some excitement as they make their way through the field.
Fingers crossed, that's one failure they won't have to worry about today, at least. There's not much of a silver lining to starting down the field with a penalty, but I think they'll be able to make some of that back up over the course of the race.
I know this is your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary risks.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go through all the gears if we can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Decent parking. Let's try and get a good launch as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Gearbox wear, so try... And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
That's a fantastic performance from Ferrari. It hardly looked in doubt. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their head when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that has allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy and stay out of trouble.
Ferrari are at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. It's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Charles Leclerc showed exactly how to manage yourself out on track today. He was almost flawless out there. Incredible stuff.
The marketing department has requested your input on this one. The department wants me to pass on their thanks for helping out.